Hi, my name's Amy. I work for the New South Wales National Parks and Wildlife Service. Today, we're going to go monitor some small mammals and reptiles using pitfall trapping in the Mallee in western New South Wales. This is what a pitfall trap looks like. But first things first, we have to get out there. We're finally there. Now, I'm sure there was a hole around here somewhere. Keep digging, Nick. There it is. We'll just take the lid off, and then you'll be able to see the pitfall hole. Now we need to put up our drift fence. Let's roll that out. It's pretty long. Good job. It's super important that we make the net flush with the hole so the animals don't know that the hole is here. That's looking pretty good. I don't think anyone will know that there's a trap here. Pitfalls trap animals as they run through the landscape, hit the fence, run along it, and accidentally fall down the hole and can't get out. There's a lot of fences to put up. How quickly can I do it? The fences are finally up, and we're back on the road to check our traps for the afternoon round. Let's see who we've caught. We've caught a Bollinger skink. They're pretty small. They live right across Australia and prefer dry environments. We're going to take some quick measurements. This one's called the snout to vent length. Once we're done measuring him, we'll set him free. It's a frosty start this morning, but look, we've caught a common dunnart. He's actually a fierce predator. He hunts insects, sometimes grasshoppers that are even bigger than he is. He's pretty mad at me, so he's showing me his teeth. We're gonna take some quick measurements. First up, his back leg. Oh, he's not too happy about that, I don't think. Nope. Then, his full body. After that, we're gonna draw a little mark in his ear, so we know that we've already caught him. And then, we can set him free. He's a little bit cold, and a little bit confused. Whoa, wrong way. That's better. Off he goes, down this goanna burrow for safety. We've also caught a gecko. We catch geckos in the morning because they're active at night, and they usually fall into the trap, sometime while we're sleeping. This one's a smooth, knob-tailed gecko. You can tell because he has a big, flat, leaf-like tail with a little knob at the end. These holes all look pretty empty. But that's pretty standard for pitfall trapping. We checked 715 holes over the last 2 weeks, and we only caught 18 animals. But that's actually a pretty good rate. It looks like there might be someone down here. Dr. Cox is going to pull it out in a little calico bag, just to make sure he doesn't run away. What have we caught? It's a southern ningowi. He's closely related to the dunnart. Also a fierce predator. This one's in torpor. It's like hibernation. He's dropped his body temperature really low, so that he could survive the night in the trap. But it means he can barely function. I'm gonna put him in his bag and put him down my jumper to help warm him up. It looks like he's all warmed up and ready to take off. I found an echidna walking down the center of the road. He was heading towards this fence. I'm just gonna pop him down here and leave him on his way. I don't know what's with the traffic today. There's animals all over the road. We've caught a little barking gecko. This guy, like all the others, is a predator, and he also eats insects. He's clearly had a run-in with someone, because he's lost his big tail. It's pretty much healed up now, though. That's all we've got time for. Thanks for coming pitfall trapping with me.